we would go to the Yiddish theatre. And there was an there were two explosions in Yiddish theatre in Australia. You know, one was it began in Carlton in 1908, which is an extraordinary story in itself. But it really took off in the late 1930s when, you know, Yonke Weislitz and Hochul Holzer, two greats of the Yiddish theatre from Poland, got stuck in Melbourne. One on a world tour, another one was visiting a relative, but they got stuck. The war broke out in the early 1940s, that stage in the Kadima. Well, they united all the little theatre groups into one big theatre, the David Herman Theatre, and all those, they put on, you know, as the old world was burning, they were putting on seasons of seven, eight different plays per year for a relatively small population, as it still was then. Of Yiddish plays, and plays everything from Freud's theories of dreams, you know, I think it was a two-hander with Hochul Holzer and Weislitz, all the way through to the Yiddish theatre classics. I mean, Weislitz staged the Dibbuk, the great Yiddish, the greatest of Yiddish plays, I think you can safely say, in 1938 at the Prince's Theatre with an audience of 1,500. Many of them non-Jews, and it took both the Jewish community and the general community by storm. And Prince's Theatre was one of our big theatres in the centre of the city. So every now and then they'd move out of the Kadima stage and go beyond that to a bigger venue. So, but then the next big explosion was the 1950s and 60s, the late 40s, when you had, coming from Poland, Holocaust survivors. And Melbourne became a large centre of survivors. I mean, it's almost like a joke. People say, why did you come to, well, it's a bitter, black, ironic joke. Why did you come to Melbourne? He says, well, we looked at the map and we wanted to get as far away from where we experienced those horrors as we could. So we came to Melbourne. But actually the reason they came here, rather than Sydney to some extent, is because in Sydney you have a more predominance of Hungarian and German Jews. There's Yiddish speakers, but it's not as strong as Melbourne. It's a classical chain migration thing, you know. So there was already something here, and they were attracted to that. So then Yiddish theatre had its heyday, you know, an audience of 6,000. And so in the 50s and 60s, going to the Yiddish theatre on a Saturday night was... That was it.